for beautiful young women.
Flying down to Lakeland, FLA, with Miss USA.
From the citrus capital of the world, Lakeland, Florida, the 33rd annual Miss USA pageant.
See us fly now, spirits soaring.
From the award-winning Broadway musical hit by one and only, our guest stars Twiggy and Tommy Thune. Our special guest star, the outstanding composer and singer, Neil Sedaka. Our hostess from the hit series, Knots Landing, Joan Van Ark. The Price is Right and one of America's favorite television personalities, our host, Bob Barker. And the Naval Air Training Command Choir.
Life's great, life's grand, futures all planned. We keep our eye on the sky, always flying, flying high.
The lovely Miss USA. 1983, Julie Hyatt.
Ring bells, sing songs, blow horns, beat gongs. We're proud, we'll tell you why. 'Cause we're flying, flying high.
Flying one way, feeling grand now. Clear the runway, gonna land now. There's a touchdown.
Ladies and gentlemen, our host for this evening, Bob Barker.
Thank you very much. That's such a long entrance, I was afraid you'd stop applauding before I got down here. I want to thank you, and I want to welcome you and our viewers to the 33rd annual Miss USA pageant, coming to you live from the citrus capital of the world, Lakeland, Florida. Tonight, here in this beautiful Lakeland Civic Center, 53 of the loveliest young women in the country will compete for the title of Miss USA. Now, you know, as many times as I've hosted this pageant, I've never said 53 young ladies before, because in addition to contestants from each state and the District of Columbia, tonight we welcome two more contestants. The first, Miss Teen USA pageant, was held right here last August, and the second one last month in Memphis. Both of those winners became eligible to compete in tonight's pageant. Our winner will receive prizes totaling more than $175,000 in cash and merchandise, and the opportunity to represent our country in the Miss Universe pageant to be seen live on the CBS network from Miami, Florida, on July 9th. Should one of our Miss Teen USA winners be our winner here tonight, she would be eligible for an unprecedented triple crown of beauty: Miss Teen USA, Miss USA, and Miss Universe, with total cash and prizes valued at close to $500,000. Now, while many of you viewers will be following along with pencil and paper, our judges here will have their votes tabulated in our computer, and the results will be announced to you at home after each competition. We'll be telling you how all that works a bit later. Right now, it's time to meet our 53 young ladies in the Miss USA Parade of States. Miss Alabama.
Kelly Flowers, Hueytown, Alabama. Sherry McNeely, Fort Wainwright, Alaska. Daria Joyce Farling, Tucson, Arizona. Shelly Boyd from Manila, Arkansas. Teresa Ring, San Diego, California. Michelle Anderson, Denver, Colorado. Lynn Scalo, Bridgeport, Connecticut. Denise Lang, Wilmington, Delaware.
Stephanie Leeming from the District of Columbia.
Stacy Hosberger, Tallahassee, Florida. Janie Poteet, Norcross, Georgia. Hoda Stillman from Honolulu, Hawaii. Valencia Billiou, Pocatello, Idaho. Levon Mizell from Chicago, Illinois.
Suzanne Mulata representing Highlands, Indiana.
Michelle Beaubert, Decorah, Iowa.
Elizabeth Johnson, Prairie Village, Kansas.
Tammy Melendez, Murray, Kentucky. Rusty Jordan, Baton Rouge, Louisiana. Vicki Lynn Gay from Portland, Maine.
Betsy Cook, Bethesda, Maryland.
Deborah Neary from Onset, Massachusetts.
Adriana Kramick, Sterling Heights, Michigan.
Martha Mark, Edina, Minnesota.
Carla Green from Biloxi, Mississippi.
Sandra Percival from Sunrise Beach, Missouri.
Christy Ogren, Frenchtown, Montana.
Joni Rundle from Omaha, Nebraska.
Donna Lee McNeil, Las Vegas, Nevada.
Diane Gajori from Hampstead, New Hampshire.
Diane Everett Qualter, Englewood, New Jersey.
I'm Mae Shanley from Alamogordo, New Mexico.
West Seneca, New York.
Cookie Nowak from Hickory, North Carolina.
Suzanne Lewis, Fargo, North Dakota.
Good evening, I'm Roxy Irwin from Pickerington, Ohio.
Julia Murdoch, Shawnee, Oklahoma.
Good evening, everyone, I'm Debbie Emerson from Portland, Oregon.
Tina Aubrey from Lancaster, Pennsylvania.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, I'm Deborah Ann Morey from North Providence, Rhode Island.
Ginger Greer, Lugoff,
Air Force Base, South Dakota.
I'm Desiree Daniels from Chattanooga, Tennessee.
Hi, I'm Laura Shaw from Burleson, Texas.
I'm Michelle Brown from Roy, Utah.
Hello, I'm Susan O'Brien from Waterbury Center, Vermont.
Mayor Rash, Williamsburg, Virginia.
Sue Garrett, Seattle, Washington.
Kelly Anderson, Clarksburg, West Virginia.
Tamara Shaw from Milwaukee, Wisconsin.
Cheryl Rawson, Laramie, Wyoming.
Ruth Zakarian, Miss Teen USA, 1983.
Cherise Halgan, Miss Teen USA, 1984.
And there are the 53 beauty delegates in the Parade of States. Have you picked out one contestant, or maybe several of them, who might be our eventual winner? We'll match your choices against our judges as our pageant progresses. But all the lovely young ladies who are here tonight are not contestants. Oh, no. For example, please welcome our beautiful and charming hostess, Joan Van Ark.
Thank you very much. Thank you. Thank you. If you out there at home love
watching these pageants like I do, then we probably watch them the same way. Grab the popcorn, we sit down in front of the TV, and relax. Well, for me, tonight is different because I'm not sitting in front of my TV, and I am certainly not relaxed. Because this is that most exciting kind of television. It's live. I mean, you're going to see everything that happens right when it happens. And this distinguished panel of celebrity judges that you see right here, they will cast their votes by means of computer terminals, just like this one right here. After each of the three areas of competition, which is swimsuits, evening gowns, and interviews, each judge will punch the score he gives each contestant into the terminal, which is connected to our computer. And that score, by the way, can be anything from, say, a 1 to a 9.99. The computer then tabulates an average score for each candidate in each category. First, the judging process will determine our 10 semifinalists, and later our 5 finalists, and one of them will be our new Miss USA. Now, you and I will get to see the scoring as it happens, but the contestants up there, the judges right over there, and the audience behind me in the theater, they won't have that information. That's just going to be between you and me. Also, we'll chat with some of the people here tonight. We're going to take a look at some of the things that happen behind the scenes, and of course, have the thrill of watching some lucky young lady's dream come true. So come on, let's get on with it. Next up is a special swimsuit fashion segment, and that'll be coming your way right after this word from Pert. In each of our pageants, our young ladies treat us to a swimsuit fashion show, which is coming up right now. This is not, by the way, the preliminary swimsuit competition, which was held on this stage right here, with all the contestants wearing swimsuits of similar design. But we will be showing you the score given each girl during that competition. The next segment takes us to various places in the Lakeland area where our contestants model fashion swimsuits from JCPenney's Miss USA collection. And to tell us about it, here's Bob.
Thank you, Joan. The lovely Lakeland scenery provided a wonderful background for the beauty of our contestants. Oranges say Lakeland, either in groves or in the yard of Mr. and Mrs. Frank Chase, one of Lakeland's first families, where we meet Kelly Anderson, Miss West Virginia, and Caroline Fleury, who is Miss New York. On a wall by a waterfall, we find Miss Connecticut, Lynn Scalo, and Valencia Bilyeu, Miss Idaho. The trees complement the leaf design on the swimsuits of Christy Ogren, Miss Montana, and Miss Alaska, Sherry McNeely. The beautiful landscape seems to have turned the head of Miss North Carolina, Cookie Nowak, who is now joined by another Southern belle, Russanne Jordan, Miss Louisiana. Wearing a suit of bold graphic design is Miss Arkansas, Shelley Boy. Azaleas and waterfalls frame Miss Rhode Island, Debbie Maury. And she is followed by the Dominion State's Leah Rush, Miss Virginia. From the Frank Lloyd Wright Design Theater, we go to the pool near the Rue Library on the campus of Florida's oldest private college, Florida Southern, where we are greeted by this lovely trio of Roxy Irwin, Miss Ohio, Miss Iowa, Michelle Bover, and our 4M lady, Martha Mork, Miss Minnesota. This twosome turns into a threesome and begins with Debbie Epperson, who is Miss Oregon, from our host or hostess state, Stacy Husferder, Miss Florida, and Miss Wisconsin, Tamara Shoof. The look of the competitive swimmer is reflected in the tank suit of Sue Garish, Miss Washington. And a combination of polka dots and pretty lady is Miss Alabama, Kelly Flowers. The other end of the Atlantic seaboard sends us Miss Maine, Vicky Lynn Gay. The classic look of blue and white stripes is shown by Susan Willardo, Miss Indiana. Two young ladies from the same state, LaVon Renee Michelle, Miss Illinois, and also from Illinois, Cherise Haugen, Miss Teen USA, 1984. From the campus, we move across Lake Hollingsworth, a favorite place for the area's water sports enthusiasts, to the Lakeland Yacht Club, where the colorful sailboats combine with more lovely ladies, starting with Joni Rundle, Miss Nebraska, and Diane Everett Coulter, Miss New Jersey. Stripes are popular this year, as shown by Donna Lee McNeil, Miss Nevada, and Sue O'Brien, who is Miss Vermont. The name's the same, but the states are different for Miss Maryland, Betsy Cook, and Elizabeth Johnson, Miss Kansas. From the Atlantic coast and the Rocky Mountains come this twosome of Deborah Neary, Miss Massachusetts, and Miss Colorado, Michelle Anderson. A variation on a man's tuxedo is worn by Miss New Mexico, Mae Shanley, who is joined by Julie Murdoch, Miss Oklahoma. On the shores of Scott Lake, we find this beautiful live oak, decorated to make any Christmas tree envious. Who wouldn't go out on a limb for lovely ladies like these? Let's begin with Miss Pennsylvania, Tina Albright. Not too far from home is Miss Mississippi, Carla Green. Purple and red are a popular combination worn here by Miss Hawaii, Huna Stillman. Still branching out, we meet Miss New Hampshire, Diane Gadore. And a young woman with roots in the South, Ginger Greer, Miss South Carolina. A little sunbathing seems to be the order of the day for Miss Delaware, Denise Lennick. And also for Miss Arizona, Darius Parling. A New Yorker who won her title in Lakeland is Miss Teen USA 1983, Ruth Zakarian. Right on deck, we find Miss Georgia, Janie Poteet. And Donna Smith, who is Miss South Dakota. The beautiful Imperial Lake Resort, which played host to all our contestants, serves as background for some of the young ladies, including Adriana Krambeck, who is Miss Michigan, and Desiree Daniels, Miss Tennessee. This is truly a cross-country trio, starting with the East's Miss District of Columbia, Stephanie Leamy. On to Mid-America's Miss Missouri, Sandra Percival. And then on to Miss California, Teresa Ring. They may not be able to lay golden eggs, but they can treat themselves to some pretty sights like Miss Kentucky, Tammy Melendez, and Michelle Lynn Brown, Miss Utah. The eyes of Texas aren't really closed. In fact, they're on you, thanks to Laura Shaw, Miss Texas. And from the Plain States, we welcome our final twosome, Cheryl Rawson, Miss Wyoming, Miss North Dakota, Suzanne Lewis. Our fashion segment closes with a look at a swimming pool at Cypress Gardens, shaped like the state of Florida. If you like grapefruit juice unsqueezed, this is the place for you. The pool is filled with 15,000 fresh Florida grapefruit and surrounded by our lovely contestants. They're joined by the reigning Miss USA, Julie Hayek, about where Lakeland should be on that map, to send greetings to everyone from the 1984 Miss USA pageant. To select 10 semifinalists from our 53 candidates was not an easy job. But our judges did it. They observed our contestants for the past week and gave each young woman a point score in our three scoring areas: evening gown competition, the swimsuit competition, and the interview competition. The scores were all fed into the computer, and each young woman received a composite score. The 10 highest of these scores determined our semifinalists. I will now pick up the computer printout that has the results, which you will see on your screens at home. While I do that, please welcome our contestants in their lovely dresses from JCPenney's official Miss USA collection. Here they are. Now, the names will not be in order of score. They will not be in alphabetical order. I will read them at random. These are the 10 semifinalists. One of these young ladies will become Miss USA of 1984. The first name on the list is Miss Oregon. Her composite score on your television screen. Semifinalist number two, Miss Tennessee. And now, come on down, Miss West Virginia. Make way now for Miss North Carolina. And here comes Miss Oklahoma. Number six on the list of semifinalists is Miss Illinois. And how about Miss Texas? Television screen at home, but it is not seen in the theater. And now, Miss New Mexico. We have two names left on this list of 10 semifinalists, and one of those names is Miss Missouri. And now we're down to the last name. One more girl who has a chance to become Miss USA of 1984. She is Miss District of Columbia. Congratulations to our 10 semifinalists, one of whom will be our new Miss USA.
Contestants, and now the number is already down to 10, but this is still very early in our competition. In the preliminary judging, our computer results showed us that first place went to West Virginia, second place went to Miss Oregon, and third place was Miss Illinois. Now we have a brand new pageant with all the previous scores deleted, and each of our semifinalists start all even again. The semifinalist competition starts with Bob Barker interviewing each of them, and that will begin right after this word from Crest.
I'm about to interview each of our 10 semifinalists, and I must admit that next to that moment when I get to tell a young lady that she's our winner, this is my favorite part of the pageant. The young ladies don't know what I'm going to ask them, and I certainly don't know how they're going to answer me. The only thing everybody is sure of is that it's live, so anything can happen. At the end of each interview, our television audience will see the contestants' average score in this part of the competition. Now, I remind you that the scores will not be seen by our panel, our contestants, or the audience here in the theater. Let's begin the Miss USA interview competition with you, Miss Oregon. Miss Oregon is Debbie Epperson. She's 21. She lives in Dallas, Oregon. And you are a full-time model, right?
Yes, sir, I am.
Now, what are your plans for the future?
My plans are, after I get done with my modeling career, I plan to design my own clothes.
Just yours? That won't pay very well.
That's true. I'd like to design evening gowns and lingerie and possibly get into costuming.
I see. Now, I have heard the young ladies say that you describe yourself as a no-talent cook. Is that right?
Well, that's kind of true. It's not no-effort cook, though. I have tried many times.
Have you ever cooked for your boyfriend?
Yes.
How did it go?
Well, one time I tried to cook him a chicken dinner, and he ended up in the emergency room with food poisoning.
Well, thank you for this interview, but please, no dinner
no
invitations.
Cooking. Okay.
Thank you.
Thank
Ms.
you.
Horrigan. You'll see her score at home, but only at home. Now you, Miss Tennessee. She is Desiree Daniels. She's 24. She lives in Chattanooga. And she's a senior at the University of Tennessee. And what are you studying?
I'm studying accounting, minoring in math.
Good for you. What would you like to do in the future?
My first love is singing, so that's really what I'm going to pursue first. And if that
well, to become a singer, you should study accounting, by all means. Yeah.
Well, I'm going to use that accounting degree so that I'll have something to fall back on should I not enjoy music or not make it in the music business.
If you become Miss USA, you'll have something to fall back on. $90,000 to $100,000 in cash. What would you do with that?
I would probably invest it, try to shelter it, possibly buy a house with it.
Do you have a financial advisor who will help you with this?
Yes, I do. I'm dating a guy that is a financial planner.
A boyfriend who
yes.
is a financial planner? Is he here tonight?
No, he's not. He's in Georgia.
I see.
And he's given me some advice should I win.
Well, I bet he has. Thank you very much, Ms. Tennessee. Check her score. And we'll talk with you, Miss West Virginia. She's Kelly Anderson. She's 23. She lives in Clarksburg, West Virginia. And she's a graduate student at West Virginia University. And what are you studying?
Speech communications.
And what would you like to do?
Well, I'm really not sure right now. I finished my bachelor's degree in elementary education. And I decided if I were going to get a master's degree, I'd pick another field so I'd be more versatile.
How much more work do you have before you get your master's degree?
I would like to graduate in December, but we'll have to wait and see. I'm hoping to get to New York for modeling this summer and see how that turns out.
Uh-huh. Now, you, some of the girls call you Stretch. Where did you get your nickname of Stretch?
Oh, I hope you never find out about that.
I found out about everything, Miss West Virginia.
When I was a freshman in college, I was the only one who could change the light bulbs in a dormitory without the use of a chair. So whenever the light bulbs went out, they would yell, "Hey, Stretch," down the hall, and I would come and do it for them. Because well, you can never find a maintenance man. So.
If we have any problem with lights tonight, we'll just shout Stretch.
Okay, I'll do that.
Thank you, Miss West Virginia. Miss North Carolina, will you join me right down here, please? She is Cookie Nowak. She's 23. She lives in Hickory, North Carolina, and it sounds as if you have a contingent here, do you?
Yes, sir, I do.
How many people here from your home?
Last count, it was 18. They come in every 5 minutes.
Well, that's good. That's
good. I've made so many friends here in Lakeland, though, it's unreal. There are a lot of people from North Carolina. It seems has moved down here, so that's just fine with me. It's
now,
great.
You have a degree in education. Are you teaching?
Yes,
is
sir.
That what you do?
No, sir, I'm not teaching right now. Well, I am teaching, just not elementary school.
What do you do?
I'm a beauty care and color consultant. I tell people, mostly women, it's a few men, but I tell women what colors they look best in.
You tell men also?
Sure.
Look
yes.
me over, Miss North Carolina. How does this red handkerchief go with my red eyes?
It's perfect. It's perfect. But I am teaching women how to take care of their skin and how to apply cosmetics.
Well, what do you tell men? Men are not wearing cosmetics that much on the street, are they?
No, they're not.
A false eyelash here and there, perhaps. But
no, but they do. They can wear either a white shirt or a cream shirt. Now, Bob, you're an exception. I'm sure you'd look good in anything. But men can look best, too.
Judges, did you hear that? Did you hear that, judges? What did you start to say?
Pardon?
You said they laughed at your remark. And you were saying something. Men should what?
You lost me.
I lost
you. Well, men should look great, too, I think.
Well, so. I do, too. Thank you, Miss North Carolina. We'll see the score at home, and now we'll talk with you, Miss Oklahoma. She is Julie Murdoch. Julie is 18. She lives in Shawnee, Oklahoma. She attends Oklahoma City University. And what do you study?
I'm a dance major there.
What sort of dancing do you do?
At Oklahoma City University, they have a theater. It's mostly theater department. It doesn't go for just ballet or anything like that, because they figure at this age you're told to be a ballerina. So it's theater dance with tap, jazz, ballet. And they also have a future toward dance teaching, so they give you anatomy, dance seminar, which is about contracts, and several other different areas.
But how is the red handkerchief with my red eyes? No, you lost me a little
along the way there.
But it sounds as if you're doing all sorts of dancing. Is that right?
Yes.
Have you been doing any dancing here?
Yes.
Have you danced with any of the boys here in Florida?
A few.
How do they compare with the dancers you danced with back in Shawnee?
They're a lot different. They're a lot more reserved here than when we go dancing in Shawnee.
Now look, guys, you got to let it hang out. You know, you can't do that.
No, I don't mean. Oh.
I think we know what you mean.
Okay.
Now, you, according to your bio, are an animal lover.
Yes.
You have pets?
Yes, several. 3 dogs, 2 cats, several horses.
What are the dogs' names?
Chuck, Bear, and Retard.
And who are the... and who are the cats?
Mama Kitty and Tom.
Mama Kitty and Tom. I don't have to ask which is which, do I?
Well, we have 4 of them that moved in, so we just gave them odd names that stuck.
If you're an animal lover, I'll bet you know what I say on The Price is Right, don't you?
Yes, I do.
What is it?
Help control the pet population. Have your dogs and cats spayed or neutered.
She wins the refrigerator. Thank you, Miss Oklahoma. You will see her score. We've had a chance to talk with 5 of our semifinalists, and you at home have either changed your mind or become even more sure of your selections. Whichever is the case, remember, we have 5 more contestants to interview.
Behind me, you can see 10 young ladies who know that one of them will be the new Miss USA. Now, we've seen and heard Bob interview 5 of them, and we'll be back for the other 5 interviews right after this from Ivory Bar.
All right, we've had a chance to meet 5 of our semifinalists, and now it's time to talk with the other 5. And will you join me, Miss Illinois, please? She is LaVon Marcel. LaVon is 19. She lives in Toluca, Illinois, and she attends the Ray Vogue College of Design in Chicago. And it sounds as if there are folks here from Illinois, or have you just made an impression here early in our show?
There are people here from Illinois.
Are there?
Uh-huh.
How many do you have here?
Well, I think there's about 15.
Now, what are you going to do when you finish studying there in Chicago?
Right now, I took a temporary leave of absence because I won my title. And I hope to try my hand at modeling, and if I do well at that, maybe I won't be going back to school.
Would you like to do this interview like we have been doing them in rehearsal, where I ask you, what is your favorite color, or what is your food? I never ask the girls in rehearsals any of the questions that I might ask on the show. Would you like to revert back to that, or should we go, what would you like to talk about?
Well, whatever you want to talk about.
Well, I'm interested in something I read in your bio. I read that you once worked for the Illinois Highway Department. Is that true?
Yes, it is.
What did you do?
I cut grass, I mowed weeds, painted.
You ran a mower?
Uh-huh.
Out on the highway?
Uh-huh.
How many male motorists had accidents while you were out there?
None of them had accidents. There were a few horns honking.
I'll bet there were. I'll bet there were. Thank you, Miss Illinois. We'll see Miss Illinois' score at home. The judges do not see it, of course. We're ready to talk with you, Miss Texas. Miss Texas is Laura Shaw. She's 19. She lives in Burleson, Texas. She attends North Texas State University. And what is your major?
My major is speech pathology and audiology.
And what would you like to do, Miss Texas?
I'd like to work in that field someday. It's a wonderful field. It's got a lot of variety in it. They're putting cleft palates in newborn babies now, and that's exciting. And you can also work with people as long as they live, sometimes over 100, have a will. They're fighting back after strokes and things like that, and that's exciting. To me, it is. And then everyone in between, too.
You don't have to be 100 years old for you to be interested.
No way.
All right. Now, I understand that you have started a journal since you arrived here in Lakeland. What are your impressions of the pageant and what's been going on here? What have you put in your journal?
I love it. I believe in any time that you have the chance to get involved in life and live it to its fullest, and that means coming here and giving 100%. And I'm taking notes the whole time on what the camera crew's doing and the lights and everybody here while we're at rehearsals. And then when we're out in the town, I'm trying to meet the people and see what's behind them. There's some neat people that have moved to Lakeland.
The producer is taking. I want you cameramen to know that the producer has some notes on what you've been doing, particularly about 3 o'clock in the morning in Lakeland. Thank you, Miss Texas.
Thank you, Bob.
Miss New Mexico, she is May Shanley. May is 21. She lives in Alamogordo, New Mexico, and she attends New Mexico State University. And Miss New Mexico, what do you study?
I'm studying elementary education.
And where would you want to teach?
Yes, I would like to teach. I'd like to teach in DOD schools, and they're the schools that I grew up, Department of Defense schools in Europe and Asia, military dependent schools.
These are schools on military bases?
Military bases. That way I don't have to speak another language.
So, you see, these beauty delegates are always thinking. They're not just beautiful, they're always thinking. Now, Miss New Mexico, are you from a military family?
Yes, my father's a chief master sergeant in the United States Air Force, and he immigrated from Ireland 25 years ago. And this truly speaks for itself, because I can just really say there's no place like home, and this is my home, the United States of America.
And yes, this would also explain your ancestral background, wouldn't it? Your mother is Taiwanese.
Yes, my mother's from Taiwan, my mother's Chinese, and my father's Irish. And so sometimes I really think that life is left up to fate, because my parents, I don't think if they ever thought about it, that they'd ever get married, but somehow they did, and they brought us to a new land, and I'm really happy for that.
Now, if they're sitting at home watching, I'll bet they're thinking, we thought about it, we wanted to get married.
Well, let me tell you, Mom and Dad, you did a good thing.
Yes, you certainly did. You tell your dad hi, tell your mom sayonara. Thank you. Score now on your screen at home, but only for you. And Miss Missouri is Sandra Percival. Sandra is 20. She lives at Sunrise Beach, and she attends Southwest Missouri State University, which is in Springfield, Missouri.
The Queen City of the Ozarks.
The county seat of Greene County.
Don't let him fool you, he's from Springfield.
I lived across the street from Southwest Missouri State University at one time. What do you study?
Electronic media, with an emphasis in television broadcasting.
And what would you like to do when you finish?
I'd like to pursue a career in newscasting.
You would like to do on-camera work, would
yes,
you?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Would you like to make your debut on CBS?
Certainly.
Would you like to just report to the folks back there in the Queen City of the Ozarks what's going on here in Lakeland? Go right ahead.
Okay. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. This is Sandra Percival coming to you live from Lakeland, Florida, where I am attending the Miss USA pageant. And the future of these 10 contestants lays in the hands of these capable judges. So stay tuned while we see who will win the 1984 Miss USA pageant.
Yay! That's great! I have one thing. I have one thing to add to that. I have only one thing to add. Look out, Barbara Walters. Thank you, Miss Missouri.
Thank you.
or for her. And we will talk with you, Miss District of Columbia. She is Stephanie Leeming. Stephanie is 21 years old. She lives in Washington, D.C., and she is a medical secretary.
Yes, sir, I am.
Where are you a medical secretary? Where do you work?
At Northern Virginia Doctors Hospital in Arlington, Virginia.
And what did your boss think when you became Miss District of Columbia?
He was speechless. He couldn't believe it.
He couldn't believe it?
No, he could not.
Didn't he realize that in his office there was this beautiful medical secretary?
I don't think he did. When I entered the Miss DC USA pageant, he didn't have high hopes for me, and when I came in the Monday following the pageant, crowned as Miss District of Columbia USA, he was shocked.
Well, we will not invite him to be a judge of our pageant. Now, you, as I understand it, are going to Europe this summer to model, is that right?
Yes, sir, I am.
And that should be exciting. Tell us about it. What are the plans?
The plans are that I will go to New York the beginning of the summer, get my portfolio ready, and I will be sent to Milan and Paris to do some print work, and then come back in the fall to New York.
And you'll be wearing these beautiful designer creations. Do you save your money to buy clothes?
No, sir, I save my money to pay my bills.
Thank you, Miss District of Columbia. The first of our three semi-finalist competitions, the interviews, has been completed. Our judges here and you judges at home have both observed that competition and made a decision based on what you've seen. Is that young lady you picked at the start of the pageant still your first choice?
Well, the interview competition scores have all been entered into the computer, and when they are combined with the scores in the upcoming swimsuit and evening gown competitions, we will learn who will be our five finalists. The interview competition results show that the judges gave the highest score to Miss New Mexico, second highest score went to Miss Virginia, and third was Miss Missouri. Now we're going to introduce our judges right over here to you judges right out there, and we're going to enjoy a special musical treat from our guest, Neil Sedaka. All that happens after this word from Mr.
The 1984 World's Fair is underway, and the Miss USA pageant sends best wishes to the host city, New Orleans. In addition to being the site of the World's Fair, New Orleans is also the title of his newest recording, the song we're about to hear from our guest, the superstar, singer, and composer, Neil Sedaka.
Down to New Orleans. Every Southern belle is a Mississippi. a trip with me. Down the Mississippi, down to New Orleans. The honeysuckle blooming on a honeysuckle vine. And the love is blooming there all the time. Every southern belle is a Mississippi queen. Down the Mississippi, down to New Orleans.
Thank you, Neil Sedaka. Thank you very much. It's time now for me to introduce the members of our distinguished celebrity panel of judges. They are the folks who have the very difficult job of selecting Miss USA. First, from the gold medal-winning USA hockey team of the 1980 Olympics and currently a member of the National Hockey League's Minnesota North Stars, here is the brilliant goaltender, Jim Craig. One of America's outstanding fashion designers, her creations are worn by some of the country's best-dressed women and are carried by more than 100 of the nation's leading specialty and department stores. She is Anna Colon. For the last quarter century, he has been the royal portrait artist to more reigning monarchs than any other living painter. In addition, he has painted 4 American presidents. He is the celebrated painter, Ralph Wolf Cowan. Another assignment from K Models involves a top fashion magazine, or one of many television magazines. We are apt to see this beauty recognized as one of the nation's most photographed models. Here is Anne Kirsten Clenchoy. An actor and dancer whose portrayal of Christopher Donlan has been a major factor in the success of the television series Fame, please welcome Billy Huffsey. A judge with an extraordinary ability to relate to our contestants is the beautiful young lady from Ohio who went on to a successful modeling career in New York after being chosen Miss USA 1981, Kim Sealbreed. Heisman Trophy winner from the University of Pittsburgh, who went on to become the all-time leading rusher for the Dallas Cowboys. He is that team's number 33, Tony Dorsett. After majoring in sociology in college, he moved to California, where he decided on an acting career. It proved to be the right choice. And today, he is known to millions as Tyler McCandless in the CBS daytime drama Capital. Here is David Mason Daniels. The part of Tyler's wife is played by a lovely young woman from Fort Lauderdale, whose dramatic training has led to roles in feature films, television movies, and of course, daytime dramas. The recent bride of Knight Rider star David Hasselhoff, she is Capital's Julie Clegg McCandless, Catherine Hickland. A radio, television, and motion picture producer whose films include Valley of the Dolls and Once Is Not Enough. He is also the author of the current bestseller, Life with Jackie. Please welcome Irving Mansfield. While starring on The Carol Burnett Show, she won an Emmy and is currently hosting a daily magazine show on cable television called The Great American Homemaker. and starring in the hit series Mama's Family. Vicki Lawrence. Thank you, judges.
Because I'm backstage here right now with beautiful Julie Hayek. I'm sorry, you're the reigning Miss USA, right?
But not for much longer.
You're absolutely right about that, because your successor is going to be chosen in just a little while. Whoever she is, just how is she feeling right about now?
Well, she's excited about having become a semi-finalist, and she's probably relieved that the interview competition is over with.
Why, do you think that's the toughest part of the competition?
Well, you'd probably get different answers to that, but I think it's the one part that the girls worry about the most, because there's no rehearsal for it like there is for swimsuits and evening gowns.
Okay, tell us all, were you nervous at this point last year, huh?
Ladies, do you think I was nervous at this point last year?
Oh, yeah.
There's your answer.
That's a good answer indeed. And as you can see and hear, our 10 semifinalists are ready for the swimsuit competition. And that'll be coming up right after this word from Scope. Good luck, girls.
The success of the Miss USA and the Miss Universe pageants relies on the people whose cities welcome us, and with that in mind, I'd like to greet some of the pageant's good friends. The Miss USA pageant especially wants to thank three lovely ladies for their support. The Honorable Peggy Brown, Mayor of Lakeland, Brenda Taylor, Chairman of the Polk County Commission, and representing the Florida Citrus Commission, Dorothy Shipes. Thank you, ladies. For the efforts expended by the city of Miami in connection with the Miss Universe pageant, which will be held there on July 9th, we'd like to recognize that city's representative, Commissioner Joe Carollo. In Pasadena, California, on New Year's Day, the Tournament of Roses Parade, which I'm happy to say I will again be describing for the CBS television audience, the Catalina float will carry Miss Teen USA, Miss USA, and Miss Universe. And marching in that parade will be the Lakeland High School Band. And for arranging... And I might point out that although I'm tone deaf, they made me an honorary member, but I won't be marching. For arranging that reunion, our thanks to the president of the Tournament of Roses Parade, Mr. James Boyle, Jr. Now, we have come to another judging area. Here he is, right over here, ladies and gentlemen. Mr. Boyle. We've come to another judging area, the swimsuit competition. So you at home had better get your pencils and paper ready. Of course, the judges here will be using their computer terminals instead of pencils, and their scores will be fed into our computer, which will come up with an average score for each contestant. That score will immediately appear on your television screens at home as our semifinalists are judged. The contestants in their official Miss USA swimsuits by JCPenney's will be seen against a background that pays tribute to the fact that we are coming to you tonight from the citrus capital of the world. Ladies and gentlemen, the Miss USA swimsuit competition. First, here is Miss Oregon.
Debbie weighs 129 pounds, stands 5 feet 10 inches tall, and is 21 years old. Debbie has hazel eyes and brown hair.
Miss Tennessee!
Weighs 127 pounds,
and is 5 feet 10 inches tall. She is 24 years old and is a green-eyed blonde.
Miss West Virginia.
Stands 5 feet 9 inches tall. She weighs 134 pounds and has blonde hair and blue eyes. She's 23 years old.
Miss North Carolina.
Is 23 years old from Hickory, North Carolina. She is 5 feet 8 inches tall and weighs 125 pounds. She has brown hair and brown eyes.
Miss Oklahoma.
Julia is a blue-eyed blonde. She is 5 feet 7 inches tall, and she weighs 118 pounds.
Miss Illinois.
LaVon is 19 years old. She has green eyes and blonde hair. LaVon stands 5 feet 7 inches tall and weighs 112 pounds.
Miss Texas.
And is 5 feet 8 inches tall. She has brown eyes and she's got blonde hair.
Miss New Mexico.
Is 5 feet 7 inches tall and weighs 117 pounds. She has dark brown eyes and dark brown hair.
Miss Missouri.
Is 5 feet 7 inches tall and weighs 120 pounds. She is 20 years old and has brown hair and brown eyes.
Miss District of Columbia.
Stephanie is 5 feet 8 inches tall and weighs 115 pounds. She has green eyes and blonde hair.
There are the 10 semifinalists in tonight's Miss USA swimsuit competition.
Thank you.
Watch contestant tonight is 21 years old, stands 5'7.5" tall, and weighs 119 pounds. Now, I could say that, but the problem is that while the numbers are accurate, there's no such thing as an average Miss USA candidate. All of them are unique and certainly way, way above average. And speaking of accurate numbers, here are the judges' scores in the swimsuit competition. They gave first place to Miss New Mexico, second place was Miss West Virginia, and third place was Miss Tennessee. Now, coming up, we have a dynamite musical number that I don't want you to miss. It's absolutely fabulous, and we'll both get to see it when we come back after this word from Folgers Crystals.
The title and prestige of being Miss USA are only part of the reward waiting for our winner. For one thing, she'll represent our country in the Miss Universe pageant, which will be held in Miami on Monday evening, July 9th. And there's more, much, much more, including $90,000 in cash. Miss USA's prize package, totaling more than $175,000 in cash and merchandise, includes a $25,000 personal appearance contract, a $15,000 first prize award, as well as the list of valuable prizes that Joan is going to describe for us with the assistance of our special models, Julie Hayek, Miss USA 1983, and Karen Baldwin, Miss Universe 1982.
This year's Miss USA will fly first class to any eastern destination of her choice. Whether it's the beautiful beaches of Florida, an enchanting Caribbean island, or the splendor of South America, she'll fly with Eastern. At Eastern, we earn our wings every day. Along with a $5,000 cash award from Minolta, our winner receives the high-performance X700 program camera and accessories, plus the advanced portable autofocus video system. Pretty pictures for a pretty lady, only from the mind of Minolta. Miss USA will receive this sporty Wellcraft 180 Elite Bow Rider from the Wellcraft Marine Corporation. She will also receive a 115 horsepower outboard motor from Evinrude and a custom trailer from Shoreline Products. Diving into any situation, our new Miss USA will be prepared when she receives, in addition to a $10,000 cash award, a 5-year supply of cosmetics from Maybelline, the official cosmetics for the 1984 Miss USA pageant. When Miss USA is sunning on the lake, she'll love to slip into something tan with Coppertone. Coppertone will present the winner with a $5,000 cash prize and a 5-year supply of Coppertone products. Our lucky Miss USA will win a $10,000 cash award plus a 5-year supply of those great natural bath and body products. She'll go natural and it will keep her fresh, fragrant, and comfortable. The new Miss USA will be in the swing of things when she receives, in addition to $5,000, a wardrobe of Candy's footwear that captures the excitement of fashion's latest trends, offering a kicky accent for any time, day or evening. Miss USA, JCPenney is going to turn your head. They're giving this year's winner $10,000 and a traveling wardrobe, including these Halston 3 outfits, part of the Halston 3 collection, designed exclusively for JCPenney. Keeping in mind the many special evenings in the year ahead for the new Miss USA, Daydreams will present a $7,500 cash award, plus a year's supply of their fragrance to our winner. Tonight's winner will be able to arrive anywhere in style, wearing this beautiful natural Emba Lunarain mink coat, modeled here at the Polk Public Museum. It's from the internationally famous Flemington Fur Company. To Miss USA 1984 goes a $5,000 cash award, a beautiful collection of jewelry, and her symbol of elegance, her crown, all from Aubrey Creations. And to the new Miss USA will go a $5,000 cash award, as well as a $10,000 fashion wardrobe by Fernando Peña. All from Secret, the official antiperspirant of the Miss USA pageant. Water skiing on Lake Hollingsworth is fun, but our new Miss USA will find she's able to go more places in more comfort when she receives one of America's most popular sports cars, the fully equipped 1984 Mazda RX-7. All these wonderful prizes for the new Miss USA.
Young people are often criticized for their taste in music, but the truth is that they often reach back a few generations for songs they send to the top of the charts. Tonight, our contestants have taken a recent hit that was written a half century ago by the great Irving Berlin and used it to pay tribute to the elegance of Florida society and its stylish manner of putting on the Ritz. Award-winning song and dance couple, Twiggy and Tommy Two.
Have you seen the well-to-do up and down Park Avenue?
On that famous thoroughfare, with their noses in the air, high hat,
an arrow collar,
white spats,
and lots of dollars,
spending every dime for a wonderful time. Stepping out with my ladies.
Can't go wrong.
With my beauty.
He's our escort, we're his dates.
I never had such pleasant duty.
Gonna dance through all the states.
I'll be smooth sailing, cause I'm trimming my sail.
Spend today in the Lakeland sun.
Got my top hat and my striped tie and my tail.
You spend the night just having fun.
Stepping out with my baby.
53 and we're in step.
Mighty sweet.
Wonderful. Whoa, here they come. Just as they are right now and for a good part of the past 2 weeks. Woo! Our young ladies have been very busy with a lot of assignments. They've had things like rehearsals and fittings and interviews and photo sessions and just generally racing from one place to another. But be sure that these young women found some time for fun. And to prove that, I just want you to take a look at this.
Thumbs up is the signal to take off as our contestants leave for the pageant on Eastern, the official airline of the 1984 Miss USA pageant. Miss Maine even sees service as an unofficial crew member, while everyone on board looks forward to being greeted by the home state's representative, Miss Florida. And sure enough, there she is. But it's right back to the sky, the famous island in the sky at Cypress Gardens, where you can get a 360-degree view without ever moving your feet. Speaking of feet, monkey see, monkey do. So Elvira decides she's going to try on the candy shoes our young ladies are enjoying so much, and her distant cousin Tiny approves. Riding through a scenic canal, this boatload of beauties decides that sightseeing is something they don't just enjoy, they flip over. both coming and going. Meanwhile, another group is moving on to some different water transportation, airboats, in a recreational preserve reclaimed from phosphate mining, one of many in the Lakeland area. This lovely scenery speaks volumes for the ecological possibilities realized by the phosphate industry. Capital idea, says Miss District of Columbia, when the famous Imperial Lakes Resort, home for our contestants during the pageant, is the site of the annual makeup clinic, conducted by Stan Place, for Maybelline, the official cosmetics for our pageant. Nothing makes makeup look better than a smile. Between the Atlantic Ocean and the Indian River, we find a place where our contestants have a different kind of competition. Wearing their fashionable JCPenney sportswear outfits, they take part in a grapefruit pick-off to see who can pick the most fruit, but with time out for a little horseplay. The combination of picking and eating gives them the experience necessary to move along to a packing plant. There they get some help from a member of the Citrus Commission that ensures quality, Dorothy Shipes. Some fruit is best for juice, and some shall be shipped as is to places as far as Japan. And like all good artists, they sign their work. Now here's a twist. At the Publix bakery, where our young ladies who take the cake also bake it. Look at that strawberry topping. It's thick. And it's rich. And it's tasty. And it's a little messy. Two more of our baking beauties mix dough, add flour, wear flour, and not only put the icing on the cake, but add an invitation, come on down, complete with an arrow that leads to a whipped cream Lakeland, and send a message to our television audience, we knew you were coming, so we baked the cake.
Just been talking about who we feel might have a chance to be our winner tonight. Bob, you've been the host for a lot of these pageants, so you should have a pretty good idea, yeah?
Well, I refuse to answer.
On the grounds that it might incriminate you? That's silly.
No. On the grounds that I might jinx some young lady, because the first 10 years, I completely destroyed the law of averages by being wrong every time. So I am protecting my ego. I'm going to leave the judging to the judges. Right. Besides, we still have the evening gown competition coming up.
You're absolutely right about that. As a matter of fact, it's coming up right after this word from Prell.
Time now for our third and last semi-finalist competition, in which our young ladies model gowns of their own choosing and the judges base their scoring on poise, charm, and a flair for fashion. As in our earlier competition this evening, the contestant scores will be made available to our television audience only. The Miss USA pageant is once again delighted to salute Armed Forces Day, which falls this year on May 19th. Our contestants will be serenaded and escorted by the Naval Air Training Command Choir and the United States Marine Corps Sword Detail and Color Guard from Orlando, Florida. The Miss USA Evening Gown Competition. First, Miss Oregon. Texas. Mexico. Columbia.
Everything that our judges have seen and heard since our semifinalists were announced has also been seen and heard by you. The votes they registered into the computer during the evening gown competition are now added in and will make it possible for the computer to tell us who our five finalists are going to be. Incidentally, in the evening gown competition, the judges gave first place to Miss West Virginia, second place went to Miss New Mexico, and third place was Miss District of Columbia.
Now, do you think that you're going to agree with our panel of judges on which of our five young ladies should become the finalists? Well, you're going to find out when we come back after this word from Crest.
I'm about to pick up the computer results that will tell us who our five finalists are. And once again, the composite score for each of our finalists will be shown to you at home as she's announced. Now, may I have the computer results, please? The names of the five finalists, one of whom will become Miss USA 1984. Good luck to all 10 of you. Here we go with the names of the five finalists. The first name on the list is Miss New Mexico. We'll see her composite score as I call Miss District of Columbia. The score is not shown to our judges or here in the theater. Number three on the list of five finalists, Miss West Virginia. And we want Miss Tennessee. And now the last name on the list. That name is Miss Missouri. Congratulations, one of you young ladies will represent our country in Miami, Florida in the 1984 Miss Universe pageant.
That you see right here are the scores that got our finalists this far. But now the competition among them begins with everyone even again. In other words, these scores no longer count, so I shall just make them disappear. David Copperfield, eat your heart out. Now, our judges will base their final decisions in part on how each contestant answers the question she is about to be asked. Bob?
I'm about to ask each of our finalists the same question. Until it is her turn to answer, each young lady will wait in our completely soundproof booth. Assisting us, two beautiful young pageant winners, Miss USA 1982, Terry Utley, and Miss Universe 1983, Lorraine Dines. Now, I would like to have you four step into the soundproof booth, please. And Miss District of Columbia, will you step over here with me, and I will give you the question first. You four step in there so that you cannot hear the answer. As each contestant gives her spontaneous and unrehearsed answer, the judges will continue their evaluation. Very well, the door is closed. Miss District of Columbia, our question is this. If you are chosen Miss USA, you'll be a Miss Universe contestant. What would you most want to tell the other contestants about your home country, the USA?
Bob, I'd like to tell the contestants in the Miss Universe pageant that the United States is a land of opportunity. We have freedom. We have the choice to do what we want. We have the moment is ours. We have freedom of speech, freedom of religion. And I would say to each of them to come join us because it is a remarkable country.
Thank you, Miss District of Columbia. Now, Miss New Mexico, would you step out to me, please? Miss New Mexico, the question is, if you are chosen Miss USA, you'll be a Miss Universe contestant. What would you most want to tell the other contestants about your home country, the USA?
Well, I would stress this is the land of the free. Having two parents who are from completely opposite parts of the world, my mother's from Taiwan, as I said, and my father's from Ireland, I know how good it is to be in the United States because I've experienced all types of life, and I realize that this is most important, to represent your country to the very best of your ability. And no matter what country you're from, make it the best and make sure that you're proud of it.
Thank you, Miss New Mexico. Miss West Virginia, would you step right down here to me, please? Miss West Virginia, if you are chosen Miss USA, you'll be a Miss Universe contestant. What would you most want to tell the other contestants about your home country, the USA?
Well, the United States is the most beautiful and the strongest nation in the entire world because we stick together. We're all Americans. And no matter you come from north, south, east, or west, we are Americans, and we're going to stick together. And I would like for everyone to come to the United States and see us, and we're all a together people. Here we are.
Thank you, Miss West Virginia. Now, Miss Tennessee, would you step out here, please? The question is this. If you are chosen Miss USA, you'll be a Miss Universe contestant. What would you most want to tell the other contestants about your home country, the USA?
The United States is definitely the most friendly country in the world. The people are so warm and so friendly. And the one thing that strikes me about America is that we have a free enterprise system and we are able to do anything that we want to do. And that is so wonderful to be able to have that freedom.
Thank you very much, Miss Tennessee. All right, Miss Missouri. Your question is this. If you are chosen Miss USA, you'll be a Miss Universe contestant. What would you most want to tell the other contestants about your home country, the USA?
I would like to tell them that it is the most wonderful country of all, but I'm sure you all agree with me on that. But there's no other place in the world where you find the freedom. It's like we're all one big family. We all strive for the same things. We're all here for the same reasons. And if one part of our country wants something, we're all there to back them up. And I think that's the most important thing, just being a family. And it's like we're a little small town in a whole world of large towns because we're close, and I like that.
Thank you, Miss Missouri. Thank you, ladies. Thank you, all five of you. We are even closer to finding out who will be the new Miss USA.
Civic Center, where we are this evening, is a proud example of the growth taking place in this area, which also respects its traditions. For a look at Lakeland that shows us there's more to Florida than sunshine and beaches, let's join the lovely Miss USA, Julie Hayek.
That's a hill, and that's a river with trees, and that's a foot. Matter of fact, that's my foot. Hi, I'm Julie Hayek, Miss USA 1983. Progress is an important word in and around the Lakeland area, especially in the field of aerotechnology. I'm here at the Flight Simulation and Test Lab at Martin Marietta Aerospace, where pilots come to help develop defense systems for military aircraft. With me is Mr. Kirk Myers of Martin Marietta. Mr. Myers, tell us how this works.
Well, the topography you've just seen is actually reproduced in this cockpit. This computerized flight simulator provides pilots with real-time simulations over a scale model terrain representing a composite of real-world geographic features.
You took the words right out of my mouth. Could you rephrase that?
Well, what actually happens is the pilots sit up here during the test and look at the monitors.
Even less complicated is something called parasailing. And instead of a parachute bringing you back to Earth, these parachutes help you to take off from a standing start on the ground. I wonder if that's as much fun as it looks. Well, now I know, and it is. The sensation of flying, plus the beautiful scenery below, really make this something special. Over there, for example, is a source of great pride for people in this area, the Lakeland Regional Medical Center. Another source of great pride is the annual Sun and Fun Fly-In, the country's second largest, held each year in Lakeland by the Experimental Aircraft Association. This is a 1931 Stinson tri-motor. It was flying as late as the end of World War II. It was later restored, and in 1981, it returned to the skies. And then there are these planes called ultralights. You might have something in your garage that can go faster, but it won't go to the places these planes will take you. Just one reminder, no frills here means no movies, no stewardesses, and the pilot is you. In this case, me. And waiting in the wings, or should I say standing on the wings, is Carolyn Pierce, who has a very special message for our contestants. I think we've proved that Florida is more than beaches and sun. It's also playing important parts in our future. In our immediate future, it's playing host to the Miss USA pageant. So let's go back to the Lakeland Civic Center.
Thank you, Julie. That was Julie Hayek's version of Come Fly With Me, and it looks like the contestants weren't the only ones who had fun here in Lakeland. A bird's eye view of Lakeland will be followed by a close-up look at our contestants. And in between, this word from Secret, the official antiperspirant of the 1984 Miss USA pageant.
The judges are still evaluating our five finalists. As a help to them, we're going to treat everyone to a close-up look at the loveliness of our contestants. The judges have monitors so that they, like you there at home, can see close-ups of our five finalists. To the perfect combination of pretty ladies and pretty music is added the musical excitement of Neil Sedaka.
I'm just a fool.
Oh,
Our thanks to our five finalists and to Neil Sedaka. The judges have finished their job, each one having made a choice for the fourth, third, second, and first runner-up, and of course for the winner. It won't be long before we know the name of the new Miss USA.
I'm here right now with Lorraine Downs, the beautiful young lady from New Zealand who was crowned Miss Universe last July in St. Louis. Welcome, Lorraine.
Thank you, Joan. Can you believe it that in 6 weeks my year will be over and there'll be a new Miss Universe?
Oh, that's absolutely right. And you know designer Don Shirley's already started work on the sets, Elliot Lawrence and Sid Smith on the musical numbers, and it's full speed ahead for Miami and the Miss Universe pageant on July 9th. Are you looking forward to it, Lorraine?
I'm excited about Miami and the pageant, but I'm not looking forward to giving up my crown.
Well, whoever she is, that lucky lady, she's going to be following in the footsteps of one of the loveliest Miss Universes ever.
Thank you, Joan. But before we start thinking about a winner in Miami on July the 9th, I'm wondering who's going to be the new Miss USA tonight.
Aren't we all wondering? But Lorraine, you and all of us are going to find out because the judge's decision, the big moment, is coming right up after this word from Pringles Light.
As I said earlier, to me, the greatest part of the pageant is when I got to tell a young woman that she's been chosen our winner. A year ago, I told that to a lovely young lady from California, and in just a few moments, I'll be saying it to another Miss USA. Whoever she is, she'll find that she has been preceded by someone who, in the past year, has brought credit to the pageant, to her family, and to herself. It's time now for our reigning Miss USA, Julie Hayek, to take her traditional walk, deliver her words of farewell, and accept our congratulations on a job well done. Here is Miss USA, Julie Hayek.
Tonight, I pass along my title, but not my memories of an exciting and challenging year. A year that I feel has enhanced my perception of the world. But enriching experiences are seldom encountered alone, and therefore, I would like to thank everyone who has been so kind to me during the past year. For their help, the people connected with the pageant, and for the love and support of my family and friends, I am most grateful. And to the new Miss USA, congratulations and go get them.
The final computer tabulated results listing our four runners-up and our new Miss USA. These results have been reviewed by representatives of the international accounting firm of Ernst & Whinney and will be given to me by Mr. John LaBarca of that firm. Thank you, John. Now, I'd like to take just a moment to say something about all the young women who have appeared on this stage tonight. Each of them made a contribution to this pageant and to the 2 weeks leading up to it here in Lakeland. While our attention now necessarily turns to our finalists, I want to thank and congratulate each of the 53 ladies we met this evening. Now, before I read these results, I want to say on behalf of everyone associated with the pageant that we would be proud and happy to have any one of you reign as Miss USA during the next year. Good luck to all of you. Now, here we go. I shall begin with the first runner-up. I beg your pardon, the fourth runner-up. Don't correct the MC, Miss Missouri. The fourth runner-up. The fourth runner-up is Miss District of Columbia. Congratulations. Now, the third runner-up is Miss Missouri. Well done. The second runner-up is Miss Tennessee. One One of you is about to become Miss USA, and the other will be the first runner-up. The first runner-up, of course, is a very important position because if for any reason Miss USA cannot fulfill her obligation for the entire year, the first runner-up becomes Miss USA. Now, I shall read the first runner-up and then Miss USA. The first runner-up is Miss West Virginia, and Miss USA is Miss New Mexico. Congratulations, Dave. Awards and all the magnificent prizes are yours. Also, the chance to be our country's representative in Miami, Florida for the Miss Universe pageant on July 9th. Now, as your predecessor, Julie Hayek, reads the Miss USA creed, you step right out there and show everyone how happy you are to be our new Miss USA.
Representing the states of the United States in the Miss USA pageant, in order to further the cause of peace, justice, and mutual understanding, we solemnly dedicate ourselves to the highest ideals of sportsmanship, friendship, and goodwill among all the people of the United States.
21-year-old Mae Shanley from Alamogordo, New Mexico, is the new Miss USA. She is currently a student at New Mexico State University. Pursue a career in elementary education. She's 5'7" tall and weighs 117 pounds. She has brown eyes and dark brown hair. Mae's hobbies include singing, acting, and dancing. Congratulations, Mae.
And now, on behalf of all of us associated with the pageant and on behalf of our new Miss USA, this is Bob Barker saying good night, everyone.
Well, tonight in Lakeland, Florida, Cinderella's name is Mae Shanley, and Mae Shanley's new name is Miss USA. We'll see her and hopefully you again on the night of July 9th, when she represents the United States in the Miss Universe pageant to be telecast live from Miami, Florida on CBS. Until then, and another magic evening, thank you all, and good night.
Portions of this program were pre-recorded.